Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to solve some critical thinking problems from our CET materials. Here, the first problem is, in a photoelectric experiment, the stopping potential for the incident light of wavelength 4000 angstrom is 2 volt. If the wavelength is changed to 3000 angstrom, the stopping potential will be, here in this question, in a photoelectric experiment, the stopping potential for the incident light of wavelength is 4000 angstrom. Here, that is 4000 angstrom for 2 volt. For 2 volt, it is 4000 angstrom. If the wavelength is changed to 3000 angstrom, the stopping potential here, the initial wavelength is 4000 angstrom. Here, this 4000 angstrom is, this is the 4000 angstrom. This 4000 angstrom is changed to 3000 angstrom. Angstrom means 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. But we know that the formula, stopping potential E V S or E V naught, stopping potential is equal to Hc divided by lambda minus work function. Hc divided by lambda minus work function. Here, the relation between stopping potential and their wavelength, relation between stopping potential and their wavelength is inversely proportional. If the lambda value is decreases from 4000 to 3000, lambda value is decreases from 4000 to 3000, here the stopping potential will be increases. Here for the 4000, stopping potential is 2 volt. For the 3000, if the lambda value is decreases, yeah, this is the lambda. If lambda value is decreases, the stopping potential value is increases. It decreases from 4000 to 3000. Now the option A is 2 volt, option B is 0, option C is less than 2 volt, option D is more than 2 volt. Here option A is 2 volt. Already it is in the wavelength of 4000. Volt is 2 volt. 0, it is not possible. Less than 2 volt, it is not possible. More than 2 volt, option D is the right answer. If the lambda value is decreases, the stopping potential value is increases. Option D is the right answer. And the next problem is, 4 electron volt is the energy of incident photon. 4 electron volt is the energy of incident photon, and the work function is 2 electron volt. 4 electron volt is the energy of the incident photon. This is the energy of the incident photon. 4 electron volt is the energy of the incident photon, and the work function is, this is the work function here, and the work function is 2 electron volt. And the stopping potential will be, here the stopping potential, according to Einstein equation, Einstein photoelectric equation, we know that the formula E is equal to H nu naught plus kinetic energy. E is equal to H nu naught plus kinetic energy. Here E is the energy of the incident photon. It is the energy of incident photon. E is the energy of incident photon. And H nu naught, this H nu naught is maximum kinetic energy of the electron. Maximum kinetic energy of the electron. Here the energy E is, the energy E is, that is 4 electron volt. That 4 electron volt is equal to energy of incident photon, and the work function is 2 electron volt. Here H nu naught, that is work function 2 electron volt. प्लस काइनेटिक एनर्जी, 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट प्लस काइनेटिक एनर्जी. द स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल विल बी, यू नो द फॉर्मूला स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल, दैट इज ई वी एस और ई वी नॉट. हियर द काइनेटिक एनर्जी, मैक्सिमम काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. फ्रॉम यूजिंग दिस इक्वेशन यू गेट काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. एज ए स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल इज द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस विच मे स्टॉप दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन, द इलेक्ट्रॉन विच मे स्टॉप दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन. लेट हियर द स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल EV इज इक्वल टू 2E, EV इज इक्वल टू 2V. देन द स्टॉपिंग पोटेंशियल दट इज Vs और VO इज इक्वल टू 2 वोल्ट, दट इज 2 वोल्ट. V इज इक्वल टू 2 वोल्ट. ऑप्शन A इज द राइट आंसर. थर्ड प्रॉब्लम, द फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक वर्क फंक्शन, द फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक वर्क फंक्शन फॉर ए मेटल सरफेस इज 4.125 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. सीज द वर्क फंक्शन, सीज वर्क फंक्शन. द कट ऑफ वेवलेंथ फॉर दिस सरफेस, इन केस ऑफ फोटो इलेक्ट्रिक वर्क फंक्शन फ्रॉम द मेटल सरफेस, द वर्क फंक्शन वैल्यू इज 4.125 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. द कट ऑफ वेवलेंथ फॉर दिस सरफेस, हियर यू नो द फॉर्मूला वर्क फंक्शन, वर्क फंक्शन. हियर फॉर वर्क फंक्शन यू नो दैट फॉर्म, डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू, डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू एच सी डिवाइड बाय लैम्डा नॉट. हियर दिस लैम्डा नॉट इज, दिस इज कट ऑफ वेवलेंथ, दिस इज कट ऑफ वेवलेंथ. लैम्डा नॉट इज द कट ऑफ वेवलेंथ. इट इज ऑल्सो called threshold wavelength, lambda naught, threshold wavelength. Here, the work function value is, this work function value is 4.125 electron volt. Converted it into joule, converted it into joule, you get 4.125 into 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. The cutoff wavelength, that is lambda naught, cut off wavelength lambda naught, W is equal to HC divided by lambda naught. Lambda naught is equal to HC divided by W. When you are here, lambda naught is equal to HC divided by W. Substitute the values here. That is 6.6 into 10 to the power of minus 34 into C value, 3 into 10 to the power of 8 divided by W value, 4.125 into 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. When you are calculating this value, we get the answer 3000 angstrom. 3000 angstrom. The option B is the right answer. And then next question, a photo cell is here, a photo cell is illuminated by a small bright source placed 1 meter away. When the same source of light is placed 2 meter away, the number of electrons emitted by photo cathode are reduced by a factor. Here the intensity is inversely proportional to square of its distance. Therefore, number of photoelectrons emitted is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. Directly proportional to intensity of incident light. But when the photocell is illuminated by a small bright source of 1 meter away, when the same source of light is placed in a 2 meter away, then get this equation 2 square. It is in the form of 1 by 4. The option D is the right answer. And the next problem is, all electrons ejected from a surface. Here, this is the surface. Electrons are ejected from this surface. by incident light of wavelength. This is the incident light. Incident light of wavelength 200 nanometer, 200 into 10 to the power of minus 9 meter, can be stopped before traveling 1 meter. Before traveling 1 meter in the direction of uniform magnetic field. Uniform magnetic field 4 newton per coulomb. The work function of this surface. The work function of this surface here. The distance d is 1 meter. The work function from that surface is, the work function from that surface is, it is half m v square maximum. It is the maximum kinetic energy is equal to ee into d, which is equal to 4 electron volt, because the electric field is 4 newton per coulomb. It is equal to 4 electron volt, but the energy of that incident photon is 1240 divided by 200. When you are going to calculate, you get this value 1240 divided by 200, that is 6.2 electron volt. Then half m v square maximum is equal to h nu minus work function. Now you get the work function of that surface, that is 6.2 minus 4 is equal to 6.2 minus 4 is equal to 6.2 minus 4. Here 6.2 minus 6.2 minus 4. Sorry. 6.2 minus 4. This is the work function. Phi naught is equal to 6.2 minus 4 is equal to 2.2 electron volt. Option D is the right answer. And the next problem is, for intensity I of a light. Intensity I of a light of wavelength 5000 angstrom. For intensity I of a light of wavelength 5000 angstrom, the work function or the photo electron saturation current is 0.40 microampere and stopping potential is 1.36 volt. The work function of a metal here. For intensity I, this is I, intensity I of a light wavelength, this is lambda 5000 angstrom. The photoelectron saturation current is 0.40 micro means 10 to the power of minus 6 ampere, and this is stopping potential 1.36 volt. The work function of a metal, from using Einstein equation we know that E is equal to work function plus maximum kinetic energy. Here, but the energy in terms of electron volt, that is 12,375 divided by 5000 angstrom. When you are going to calculate, this value becomes 2.475 electron volt. And the maximum kinetic energy is equal to EV naught. You know this form, but here it is, this is stopping potential. Maximum kinetic energy is equal to stopping potential, that is 1.36 electron volt. Therefore, here from using this equation, you get 2.475 electron volt is equal to work function plus 1.36. Then work function is equal to 2.475 minus 1.36. You get the answer. Work function is equal to 1.1 electron volt. 1.1 electron volt. Option C is the right answer. And the next problem is, the frequency and work function of a, the frequency and work function of a incident photon are, frequency and work function of a incident photon or mu and The frequency and work function of an incident photon, frequency and work function of a incident photon are nu and, here this is nu and nu naught, here this is nu and nu naught. If nu naught is the threshold frequency, then the necessary condition for the emission of photoelectrons is the frequency and work function of an incident photon are nu and nu naught. The frequency is nu and the work function of an incident photon is, that is, nu naught. Now the threshold frequency and necessary condition for the emission of photoelectron will be, and suppose if I consider this is the surface, a ray of light wavelength is incident on the surface of this metal, the electrons are emitted. Electrons are emitted above the threshold frequency. Below the threshold frequency, where it requires minimum energy to liberate the electron from this metal surface. At this condition, nu is greater than or equal to nu naught. Nu is greater than or equal to nu naught because nu, it is incident frequency, greater than or equal to, here incident frequency, and this is threshold frequency. Threshold frequency means it is the minimum frequency below which no photoelectric emission takes place. Here nu is greater than or is equal to nu naught. At this condition only the photoelectrons are emitted from this metal surface. Below this condition or below the threshold frequency, there is no electrons or emitted from the metal surface. Here the option C is the right answer. And the next problem is, if E1, E2, E3 are the respective kinetic energies of an electron, an alpha particle and proton. Here the energy, that is E1, energy for the electron, and E2, this is energy for the alpha particle, and third point here E3, this is energy for proton, having the same de Broglie wavelength. Here m1 is the mass of the electron, m2 is the mass of the alpha particle, and m3 is the mass of the proton. According to the relation, E is equal to half mv square, or energy is equal to, you know this form, energy is equal to half mv square, or here 2e divided by m, root of 2e divided by m is equal to v. Root of 2e divided by m is equal to v. Then the wavelength, that is lambda, is equal to h divided by root of 2m into e. Here the energy and their wavelength, they are inversely proportional to each other. They are inversely proportional to each other. Here m1 means the mass of the electron. Mass of the electron is less than mass of the proton. M3 is the mass of the proton. It is less than mass of the alpha particle. From using this form, I can construct this formula. M1, this is mass of the electron, is less than mass of the alpha, mass of the proton is less than mass of the alpha particle. Here M1, M2 and M3 are the mass of the electron, mass of the alpha particle and mass of the proton. And M1 is less than, M3 is less than M2. The relation between wavelength and mass is inversely proportional. Therefore, here the energy E1, the relation between energy and, sorry, relation between energy and their wavelength. Here energy of the electron is, energy of the electron is greater than the energy of the proton, is greater than energy of the alpha particle. E1 is greater than, E3 is greater than E2. E1 is greater than, E3 is greater than E2. Option A is the right answer. Next question. The work function of a aluminium is, the work function of an aluminium is 4.2 electron volt. This is the work function. Value is phi naught. If two protons each of a energy is 3.2 electron volt strikes an electron of aluminium, then the emission of electrons here, the work function value is work function. It is the minimum energy required to liberate the electron from the metal surface. Here from this metal surface, the electrons are liberated here. Here, when the electrons are liberated from this metal surface, it requires 4.2 electron volt energy. Below this 4.2 electron volt energy, electrons are does not liberated from the surface. But if two photons, each of energy 3.5 electron volt, strikes an electron of aluminium, then the emission of electrons will be possible, will not be possible, data is incomplete, depends upon the density of the surface. Here, for emission of electron, incident energy of each photon must be greater than the work function. Here, this is the less than the work function. The work function is 4.2 electron volt, but the incident energy is 3.5 electron volt. For the emission of electrons, incident energy is must be greater than the work function, or it is must be greater than the threshold energy. It is not possible. Option B is the right answer. Next problem. In photoelectric emission process, from a metal of work function 1.8 electron volt. This is 1.8 electron volt. This is the work function. The kinetic energy of most energetic electrons is 0.5. This is the maximum kinetic energy of K. Maximum kinetic energy is 0.5 electron volt. The corresponding stopping potential is here. The stopping potential is equal to, you know that form, K maximum is equal to E into Vs or E into V naught. The stopping potential is always equal to kinetic energy. Stopping potential is always equal to kinetic energy. The stopping potential value or the kinetic energy value is 0.5 electron volt. And then in photoelectric emission process, from a metal of work function is 1.8 electron volt, then the corresponding stopping potential is 0.5 volt. Option C is the right answer. Next problem. Radiations of two photons energy twice and 10 times the work function. Radiations of two incident photons energies twice and 10 times the work function of metal or incident on the metal surface successively. The ratio of maximum velocities of photoelectrons emitted in two cases. Here, we know that the simple formula half mv1 square. Here, the radiations of two photons energies, this is the first photon energy, half mv1 square is equal to twice. It is twice. That's why I read this equation 2w0 minus w. And 10 times the work function, that is 1 by 2 mv2 square is equal to 10 times the work function. Here, from using this formula, you get work function W naught. Here, this is 9 times of work function. This is the twice. Here, twice minus work function, you get this form W naught minus 9 W naught. The ratio of maximum velocities, the ratio of these velocities, the ratio of maximum velocities, that is V1 by V2 is equal to root of work function divided by 9 times of work function. You get 1/9. The answer is 1/3. The ratio option B is the right answer. And the next problem is, a proton has kinetic energy. A proton has kinetic energy E. Here, A proton has a kinetic energy E is equal to 100 kilo electron volt, which is equal to that of a photon. The wavelength of photon is lambda 2 and the wavelength of proton is lambda 1. This is the wavelength of photon and this is the wavelength of proton. The ratio of lambda 2 divided by lambda 1. The ratio of lambda 2 divided by lambda 1. You know that form E is equal to hc divided by lambda. E is equal to hc divided by lambda, or lambda is equal to hc divided by E. This is equation number 1 for photon. Then for proton, it is in the form of half m mass of proton and v square photon. Mass of proton and v square photon, it is equal to half m square photon and v square photon divided by m. When you write this equation in terms of momentum, you get p is equal to root of 2m into e. But from using de Broglie equation, you know the formula lambda is equal to h by p, or p is equal to h divided by lambda 1. This is lambda 2, and then you get lambda 1 is equal to h by p, or h divided by, that is momentum, 2m e into e. Therefore lambda 2 divided by lambda 1 is equal to hc divided by, this is lambda 1 equation number 2. Lambda 2 divided by lambda 1 is equal to hc divided by e into, hc divided by e into h divided by root of 2m e is directly proportional to root to the power of minus 1 by 2. Here these are the options. This is e square, e to the power of 1 by 2, e to the power of minus 1. This is e to the power of minus 1 by 2. Option D is the